Hello all, no respawns. Hope you're doing well. So you had a good hope you had a good Easter weekend. Also, wait for it. Oh, I fell down. I left that in because it made me giggle. So yeah, hope you had a good Easter weekend, whatever you ended up doing. I personally did fuck all, which is always what happens to me. Whenever I have any kind of public holiday, I become uncharacteristically lazy. Thence no videos. I just can't be asked to do anything at all. Like, literally. Anyway, so this build is a sort of apartment block, or block of flats, or not really a block actually, that's a very, very misleading title. It's basically flats, effectively, in the castle for people to live. But this build will work really well in any area, like the castle, or like the place I was thinking of was Hangman's Alley especially, that has quite a limited amount of space, and you kind of have to make use of what you've got, because obviously this is the second tier of my little castle build. This is me just doing the top level. So before I just ramble on again, the reason why I'm doing what I'm doing right now specifically is because I want a floor leading to the roof of this little structure. I want to put that floor in first so I know that it matches up with the little ramp they made in the last video. So yeah, but this is really good for kind of making use of the space. And the reason for those boards right there, these walls, is so I can then match the wall up to the edge. You'll see why, just because it means it's sheer and looks all correct. So yeah, this turned out quite well. So this is obviously my second tier of my castle. I'm going for a vaguely megaton thing. I keep saying vaguely now because I'm worried. I think it's going to look really cool, and it's inspired by megaton, but I am conscious a little bit that it might not actually be as megaton-esque as I'd like. Now, what we're going to be doing, and the whole idea of this, is I'm going to duplicate what I've done here. So that little tower kind of walkway we did in the last video that we just walked up. And also this little apartments, flats, whatever the fuck they are, things. The place where dudes live, yeah? Is going to be kind of duplicated on the one side. So what I'm going to do, is I'm not going to show you me doing that. I haven't actually done that as of me recording right now, but I am going to do those possibly before the next video, or maybe just afterwards. I might do it afterwards actually, because I can just kind of squeeze them in. But we're going to have one set piece structure. So these like flat and that walk and that ramp thing will be duplicated, and then we'll have one kind of set piece structure that will just kind of be a, maybe I was thinking maybe a chapel or something like that in the castle, so we can actually have some, just something to kind of draw the eye. And then after we've done that, we'll have like the top, we can do the kind of castle walls, which are a little bit more, should we say, less restrictive than what we're doing now. Because that's kind of the big issue a little bit with this section of the castle, is it's a little bit niche. So I'm trying to do stuff, one, limit how many unique structures I do, so that way I'm not, you know, doing 5 or 6 videos or something, which is me just going, this stuff is very unique to this specific area of the castle. But instead just kind of doing stuff kind of, that's why this stuff will be quite useful for places like the old Hangman's Alley. This looks pretty cool, this, what I do. You'll like it. Also, if you look over, I have to look over, as if you can turn the camera, yeah? You can actually, because this is now a virtual reality video where you can interact with everything I'm fucking doing. Of course you can, you David, you twat. But basically, so I've got my little kind of trading stop, right? Well, the traders come in the wee centre over there. Now, if you glance over when I walk by, you'll see there are loads of people in there. Because basically, they can get in, but they don't leave. No, it's fine, don't worry. Because it's only when you hang around in the settlement for ages do they kind of, shall we say, start to build up. But it did make me giggle. Like, when I went to do the tour in this, you've got every single trader. Now, they do fuck off, so don't worry. But yeah. I think it might, there's a mod I need to do, like an install AI pathing mod, which I haven't got around to fucking doing yet. I need to go around and kind of check their pathing. They're getting in, but they're not getting out. Though, just to think, because I do, you'll see in the tour, I put a few farms, a roof, kind of like a little kind of, those concrete block roof garden things that I've made before. I put a couple of them on the roof, just because it looks nice. And they actually attracted settlers, so I had settlers up here, which is cool. So, like, my image, right, is I wanted to kind of make this feel... So, I was really... I didn't want to do block structures. Now, actually, admittedly, this is a vaguely blocky structure in terms of the actual, like, shacks. But in terms of how it looks out when it's finished, it doesn't feel blocky, you know? And it's really well decorated, so I'm quite pleased with this. So, I tried to... I kind of had a vague idea in my head of how I wanted this to look. But also you may notice that it's quite open on the bottom. Now what we do is we build some kind of supporting block things that you can't actually go into. I'll do them in a minute. But basically the castle, this area underneath, I'm going to do a detailed tour, but a lot of it won't be me showing you what I'm doing, because it'll be kind of a lot of... I might show you a little bit, I'm not too sure. It depends how complex it is, if I feel I need to do a guide on it, or whether I could just kind of show you and go, look, I just blocked this over. Because basically, to give you... Because you've got the two doorways here, right? I'm going to make it so that you're funneled to them, but that you can't actually... Like, there's going to be a doorway leading to those staircase, and you're going to kind of not be able to... You're still going to be... It's going to be quite closed off. That's the whole idea, but it's not going to be anything really fancy. It's just me kind of using the pre-existing buildings I've built here now and just kind of extending the bottom bits and blocking them off so you can't actually... It's not as... It doesn't feel as open on the bottom. I absolutely love this ramp thing, though. So cool. But you'll see what I mean when I do it. I have lots of building here to do. Like, lots of building kind of... It's going to take a while. But at least I know what I'm doing. Just a couple of blasts, actually, and which is, I don't know why this is, but it's grand. I haven't had any frame rate drops at all yet while doing this, and I don't actually think I'm probably gonna. Now, the reason being, I think, is one, obviously, there have been stability patches since, obviously, since my old castles, you know, back, kind of fucking March last year, almost. But also, we're using mods. So we're using lots of complete structures. So basically, the kind of too long didn't read of it all is that my old builds would have probably used a lot more in-game pieces than what I'm actually doing right now, which is interesting. Like, I haven't seen a single frame rate drop. I'm also using a few, like, less light sources, I must admit. Like, my old builds tended to cover them in lights, and that's a bit of a shitey problem. As you can see, I'm being quite kind of lax. I'm going to lapse with it in a lot of ways and just kind of making things look a little bit kind of junky. I don't know if I'm going to link up all of these walkways yet. Maybe, but you'll see them when I'm done. I've kind of just put railings around the edges, so they're quite... It should be quite straightforward for me to fix if I want to kind of add bits and pieces. This looks weird, but I like it. I was trying to think of what, like, as always with these castle vids, I was trying to think what to call this one. I was like, what is it? Is it a flat? It's kind of, I'm going to call them apartments, probably castle apartments. So sorry if maybe I'm spoiling it a little bit. And they're not really apartments, but they're kind of apartments. They're apartment-ish. The reason why I did that staircase just there is this is the scaffolding stairs. It's thin, which is the most important part, and it also doesn't snap on. But I put it into two. The reason being is then I can just do what I'm just doing here. Being a prick as it is, yeah, and then I can just snap the wee staircase on after I've snapped this floor on, and that will allow it. I do pull it back a little bit when I'm decorating, by the way, because it's a bit too far forward. You'll see it snap in a little bit much. See, looks a little bit stupid, so pull it back a little bit, yeah, or just, you know, pay attention to where it joins, basically, because this way you've got like a staircase in but without actually blocking up the room. Getting because of how stupid they do the stairs in this, and there are no such thing as ladders in Fallout 4, because, well, there are, but, you know, you can't actually climb up them, because that apparently would be too complex just to make it so you can climb up fucking ladders. It means that any way that we get up a side of a building has to be staircases. And seriously, unless you build a lot, you don't realise how annoying internal staircases are for... It fucks everything up, people. It fucks everything up. See, I'm going with these double railings now. I don't give a shit. Back in the day, I hated double railings. Now I'm like... Don't care, living on the edge, you know. So you can see it's like looking quite scrappy now, quite kind of weird looking. I changed these around a little bit and then make them kind of like shite doorways. The decoration of this is on point, you will like it. I also spent about, highly recommend you get the Freemaker mod. Just search Freemaker, and it comes up with Freemaker. That's what it's called. And what Freemaker does is it allows you to like kind of cheat your resources. Which I do now, because I don't buy any shipments anymore. Used to never glitch, now I'm like, I've got mods, fuck off, I'm not spending an hour a day fucking pulling loads of shipments. But also, it's more importantly, it's for decoration, is you combine it with OC Decorator, and what you can do is you can basically just go through, I go through the entire MISC menu, because you go up to, you basically go into the chemical stations, and it's got loads of new menus for like ammo, salmon supplies, and one of them is junk misc. And I just go through the entire junk misc section. It doesn't cost anything. I think it might cost a cap. No, I don't think it costs anything. And you just go through, and I just keep giving myself kind of like 3 or 4 of every single item. So when I go to decorate an OC decorator, because it just puts the item in your inventory and you can just drop it off into the workstation, it means that I can basically just put whatever the fuck I want down. And it just, it's really, really easy. So I highly recommend OC decorator and freemaker for your junk decoration needs. It's pretty cool. So I wasn't too sure initially how I was going to do the bottom areas, and then I landed on the junk walls. This is inspired, those who remember, I did my, what do you call it, me steel houses. Inspired a little bit by that, just reversed. It's just quite a good technique to kind of add a little bit of, I love these, basically, big ass junk walls, because they just add a lot of shit. They're good, they're supports, look at that, looks nice. There we go. I was actually going to have it flipped, so it looked like it was supporting it, but I couldn't. And I also forgot to put the walls on that part. I had to change it up a little bit, because the surfaces were a little bit sheer, but it's fine. I fixed that in the decoration part. God, this settlement looks awesome, doesn't it? Doesn't it? Yeah, it does. I'm especially pleased with just, well, everything about it. It looks great. Oh, it's going to be so good. And the pathing isn't too bad, as mentioned. I'm quite chuffed with how these turned out as well. It's good, because now I've got these, right? I have to do just duplicate what I've done here, that ramp and this, and then all I need is one more big set piece building for the second tier, and that's it done. It's just going to take a bit of a while to figure out something. I don't know what it'll be, basically. I said possibly a chapel, but I might do that, because I do want kind of a wee chapel, but I don't know where I'm going to put it. So what I'm doing right here, this is a useful technique for the lazy among you. So initially, I was going to make these kind of this area here, apartments, so we're gonna have like rooms underneath, and then I realized fuck that, because they'll be tiny little rooms, they'll be crap, and it's just really awkward. So instead I basically just make these, as you'll see in a second, I put these bits on the bottom, and this is just matching it to where the floor is, where the walkway is, right? And I basically am doing, this will effectively be the support, and then I'm going to put a junk fence, you'll see in a sec. It's just a very sneaky way of doing it. I do it a lot on my builds. Whenever I don't know how to use an area, or whenever I just want to kind of fill a void, I do this. Because basically what I've done here is this enabled me not have to worry about decorating a bottom level. I don't have to worry about this part at all. I don't have to, you know, try and work out an entrance way. And it's just, it's an easy way of doing things. It's also sneaky as fuck. I do this a lot. Highly recommend doing it. The other side's a lot easier because it's not weirdly shaped, as you can see. The only reason this is difficult is because of the walkway that I've got going around, but it's fine. So you just pop that in there like that. Or we don't. Do we? No, we use half walls, don't we? I remember now. It was only about, what, an hour ago since I did this, but, you know, I remember now because I can remember things. It's pretty simple. And put the junk fence walls in. Probably didn't need to show the entire thing, but oh well. I did cut out quite a lot of the video though, because there were lots of it. As you can see, I just walked through a little reverse junk fence doorway. I was going to start actually adding the detail on the area around here. So as you can see, we've obviously got this castle entranceway. You know, for example, the walkway, there'll be a staircase or a ramp leading up, and kind of this little staircase area. But that would have just extended the video quite a long time, and I want to spend a lot of time there. So I don't know if this kind of, what I kind of, distraction chaff building, I guess, where I'm just filling these little areas, where I'll do a video on it, or whether I'll just kind of, you'll see it in the tours. It just depends how complex it is, because I would no idea how long this will take. But as you can see, it's quite a clever little techniques. It just kind of allows you to block off this area. It also looks kind of cool as well. I kind of leave some of the supports on, so it just looks kind of weird. I was going to put it on both sides, but that just wasn't working. I love these ball track supports, by the way. You need the contraptions DLC for those, just for the record, or people always forget. There we go. That's looking really good, actually, this. You'll like the decoration. So I'm quite pleased with how this castle's. I really want to, because basically, I've mentioned this before, but I've been periodically playing Fallout. So like what I've done, I've completed the game before, and on this save I've been drip feeding myself quests over the last like year, basically, because I want to kind of do a little bit of questing as I go, so I can feel kind of engaged with the game. However, because the fact that where I am in the main story, I can't do anything else until I finish the castle, because I want to hopefully be able to do the castle invasion, and to do that, I can't do any more story quests, and there are no side quests for me to do. So I really want to finish this so I can actually start questings again. So here, I can just basically just slap this underneath, just slap a prefab. I could have turned this into a room, and I could potentially later on, maybe like, for example, just remove the wall, and like when I do the walkway in and just have like a little box structure underneath. I may, but I may not. But this kind of just fills it up. Let me see, you've got the junk wall here. I love these new junk walls. I mean, they're not new, but they come with the Unlock 7 Objects mod. And they're great because the other junk food walls have a bit too much going on the front of them. So like if I did this, it would like kind of glitch through and they'll be showing. So here's the tour. Anyway, so you quite like this. So you've got the ramp. Then you've got the walkways. Look at this. Look at this. I see the dudes up there as well. So they look a bit ridiculous when they're working the flowers. And this is just the view because it looks amazing. You can see a couple of the traders down there. So I added these kind of crops up here because I thought it looked quite nice. And you go in here, lots of junk and detail. This is quite cool. This will look really well, good in Hangman's Alley. It's a nice use of space. I wanted to kind of give it less of a box structure feel, even though it is kind of box structure in the actual structures. But also kind of, I wanted loads of areas that you could look out over the settlement. Because obviously there's, that guy's just doing squats over there, because as you do. But it just kind of, there's quite a lot to see. And I wanted you to be able to, whenever you're walking around the settlement, to be able to look at everything. Anyway, hope you guys like that. Gives you a few ideas. Definitely a good one for kind of places like Hangman Alley, where you've got a limited amount of space. As always, follow me on Twitter, @norespawns. I'll have a new video up soon. I'll really try and hurry up a little bit, because I don't want this castle to take 12 more videos. I want it to be about maybe 4 or 5 and have the whole thing finished. But anyway, you guys enjoy the rest of your week. You take care.